whereas our actual sales order process starts from sales order. And most of the times, like we treat the pre-sales activities as optional ones, which means if you have created the inquiry and quotation, it is fine. And if you don't, if you haven't created also, it is fine, no problem. But for our purpose, the process starts from sales order, and sales order is the mandatory sales document. So that is why, in fact, if you go to interview, they will ask you like, can you please explain the OTC process? OTC means order to cash. Okay. So sales order to cash means sales order, delivery, billing, and receiving the incoming payment. So this is the OTC cycle, order to cash cycle. Okay. And anyway, like first of all, we'll go through two cycles today. One is the including the pre-sales cycle, and second one is direct sales order. And we are going to use the concept of referencing. Referencing means you are going to reference an already existing document, and you copy the data from that document directly, and then you are going to process it. Of course, while referencing, you can add new items or delete existing items, or you can modify the quantity. Whatever is possible, we can do that. So to start with, let us start with the inquiry. So logistics, sales and distribution, sales, inquiry, create. So before that, can anybody tell? WebEx link, I sent you, Sirisha. I sent you on Gmail. Anyway, I will paste it in Skype now. I did it. Okay. Before proceeding, do anyone remember how I can display the transaction codes along with it, so that I can familiarize myself with the transaction code? I go to extra. Settings, good, a round of applause for Preeti. Okay. So this is the way you normally familiarize yourself with the transaction code. Okay. So if you are very familiar with the transaction code, then after a while, like, you can start entering the transaction code directly, which will save you some time. So I am going to create a inquiry first. So my inquiry type is IN. Okay. I mean, like if I press F4, I can get what are all the possible entries. I can get a drop-down box. Okay. I have inquiry. This inquiry somebody else has customized or created for themselves. Okay. So let me use the standard inquiry IN. Okay. In inquiry, I am entering the customer number. Yes, 2A01. Okay. First UIRY. Okay. I'm entering the material number T-AT101, T-AT201. Okay. This I give 25 pieces. This I give 50 pieces. Okay. So this inquiry, in real time, what happens, you will receive the inquiry from your customer. Basically, they will be sending you a mail or fax saying that I am in need of so-and-so material and so-and-so quantity. Can you please quote your best prices and delivery time for this? So they will be sending that. Why we are doing that in our system? It's like, it looks like as if we are creating inquiry, not we are receiving the inquiry. The thing is, so we are recording their inquiry in our system. Okay. At some point, we have to make the data entry in our system. Okay. So that is what we are doing right now. Okay. We are entering the Okay, fine. We are recording the customer's requirement in the form of inquiry in our system, and we take the validity for the inquiry. So I am saying that my inquiry is valid till the end of this month. I didn't enter anything else. Yeah. Pricing part. Okay. Select that and go to the item conditions. There is a coin event there. Actually, I must have this master data is not maintained properly. Yeah. So as of now, I just maintained by entering this. Anyway, I have to maintain it in the separate transaction prices. Okay. So I have made that. Okay. I have entered the validity. This inquiry is valid for up to this month end only. When I enter the inquiry, I am not making any commitments or any, I am not committing anything to my purchasing or production department so that they can plan their production or purchasing. It is just a information which I have received from the customer. So I have just received it and I have just parked it, let's say. So this inquiry details is not transferred to any of the other modules. Okay. Now I have created an inquiry in my system, and now my salesman, he goes through that. Okay. After going through that, he says he is now going to give the quotation. Okay. My quotation type is QP, and if I am not having the inquiry in my system, I can press enter directly and then go and create. Okay. But since I have an inquiry already, I am going to create a quotation with reference. So I am clicking with reference. Okay. The system is asking me the number. Which one? 04. Okay, that is for that. Okay, here you press that F4. Then you can give the customer number. Okay, my sole to party to whom I am making the sales order is 162801. My distribution. I am narrowing down. If I don't give the distribution channel and division also, I will get. But only thing is, I am just narrowing them. If there are so many entries for that. Yeah. So I am taking this. Okay. 15. I had added 2 zeros extra. Okay. Here I have the option to. There are two options for me. One is copy and another one is item selection. If I select copy, the system will copy everything from the inquiry and then put it into my quotation. If I select the item selection, if I choose the item selection, then I am given a choice of choosing only the materials that I need to copy from inquiry to quotation. For example, I had recorded the inquiry, but let me say I want to quote for only one item, that is AP101. Else, I want to give for either AT201 alone. Okay, which means I want to keep the other one. I can unselect the one which I don't want to quote for, and then I can copy. Okay. So as of now, let me go for both the items, no problem. So if I want, I can change the quantities here. Let me say that everything comes in 12 pieces per carton. So I am saying I can give for 24 pieces and this one for 48 pieces. Okay. I copy that. And like why I made a changes in the quotation that you will see. Okay. Once again, I have to maintain the PR00. That's the problem. Is the second one maintained? Yeah. Second one price is maintained. First one only is a problem. Okay. So now I have created the quotation. Normally, when you give a quotation to the customer, again you give it a validity. It's not like the customer can come back after 2 years saying that you had given me this price. So I want to buy the materials at the same price. It's nothing else. So you have to give the valid to. This valid to is an important field in quotation, and it equals to your, I mean, if you don't fill this, it will, the system will name the document as incomplete. So I'm not filling it right now, and let me go to edit incompletion log, which means that I want the system to tell me what are the things I have to fill but I hadn't. It means why I have made the system as incomplete. The system says I must enter the quotation valid to. So I select that, go to complete data. My quotation is valid till 31/7/2001. Okay, that's my system. In the status bar, can you see the message? The document is complete. It doesn't copy the, no, it doesn't copy the validity as well as the price. Okay, it just copied the, that settings we can do that. I have to, let me look into the settings what they had made actually. Okay, then I am saving this quotation also. Is it clear? Till now, two steps we did. One is creating the inquiry and second one is creating the quotation. Is it clear till now? Preeti? I know, Sirisha can manage. Okay. So that's why I didn't ask her. No, no, so I told Sirisha can manage, that is why I didn't ask Sirisha whether it is clear. Okay. So then I go to create sales order. I can create sales order directly just by pressing enter. Okay. But I don't want to create enter, I mean create a sales order right from scratch. Since I already have a quotation in place, I want to make use of this quotation. So as usual, I enter the document type and I press the create with reference. Then the system shows me the quotation. There I enter the quotation number. As usual, I have the choice to choose between the two articles. Sometimes it happens like you might have quoted for 5 articles, but the customer will come back for only 3 articles. And sometimes for all the 5, he will be coming with a changed quantity. So that is why that you can make those changes in the item selection. So as of now, since we had changed item selection in our previous step, let me go for copy directly. So system has copied from quotation. Okay. So this is my sales order. This is how my sales order looks. Okay. The sales order is divided into yeah. The first day's column is taken because, can you see there is something called as required delivery date? I am highlighting. This is the, if this is in the, yeah. System is copying is this value into all the lines. So which means, whatever item you enter, the system says the first delivery date requested is 2507. But if I make any changes here, the system will not copy this change back to this place. It will just give you a warning that it is not copied to your. So let me say like I am making it for 26. Based on the availability. Yeah. So, yeah, let me say like there are 2 items right now. If I do that, it will go for delivery split. I don't want to do the delivery split for your first sales order itself. Okay. So, as of now, let us say like, okay, the system is taking this date. Okay. On sales order level, the data is being taken at, is maintained at 3 levels. One is called as header, and second one is item, and third one is schedule length. Okay. Header means it is in the header part of the sales order, which applies, and the data is applying for the whole sales order. For example, In the header data you have the details of customer, okay, because this customer, the whole sales, the customer data is common for the whole of the sales order. That is why it is put at the header level. In which sales area this sales order is being created for, okay, and which sales office this customer is being served from. These two fields are taken from your customer master. And which currency this customer is being, this sales order is being processed, that is also taken from your customer master directly. However, you can change the currency at the item level. Okay. This price list, price group, this customer group, sales district, everything comes from the customer master. Okay. Similarly, it says like, it didn't give any shipping point here. Okay. It just says where the goods has to be unloaded at the customer's place. Okay, that is the unloading point. And what is the shipping condition for this customer? Whether it has to be a standard delivery or as soon as possible or emergency. So that is the shipping condition. And next one is the order combination. Whether for this customer, if there are more than one sales orders that are due for delivery for the same date and starting from the same delivering plant, then the system can combine those sales orders into a single delivery. If you want to enable that functionality, you can choose the order combination. Else, if you want to say that I want deliveries separately for each sales order, I don't want any combination because I don't want to lose track at a later time, then you can uncheck this so that the system creates delivery for each sales order. Then there is something called as complete delivery. If your customer can agree for partial deliveries, it is fine. If your customer is very much insisting on the complete delivery, then you mark it as complete delivery so that the system makes sure that even though the goods are not available right now, it will wait for a while to make a complete delivery. Okay. So I want you to do the remaining part. What are the masters we have seen? Customer master, material master, CMIR, customer metal info record, and prices. Do one thing, go through all these tabs, okay, open each field and find out from which field this is getting populated from. Because when we created a sales order, what we entered only the customer master, material number, and the quantity. We didn't do anything other than that. But the system is automatically taking all the fields from the masters. So if you go through each of the tab and in each field, if you see which is populated, then you must know like from which field, from which master data this field is getting populated. Whether, for example, I told you that this sales office, sales group, price list, price group are coming from the customer master. Okay, this usage will be coming from your customer material info record, CMIR. If you had maintained usage in the CMIR, you will be getting that. Okay. Shipping also you normally take from your customer master, whereas this weight, total weight, net weight are coming from the material master. Okay. So I want you to go through each tab, and find out from which field, from which master data each field is getting populated. Okay. Then we go to the item level data. Item level data is the data that is pertinent to only those data items. Okay, only to those items, not for the other items also. For example, if I select 10 and see the item data, that is relevant for only item 10. Not that it is in the item level, it will apply for other items also, not that. Okay, so let me choose that line. Either I can double click to get into item data, or I can click the display item details. Okay. If you go to display item details, the system once again it carries a set of tabs. The first tab says like what is the quantity, what is the first delivery date, which the system automatically required. The system required the first delivery date on 26th. Okay. Then let pricing date. First pricing date. Pricing date, like there are certain articles whose prices is normally fluctuating. For example, steel prices are there. You know, like steel prices are almost volatile like gold prices, which is they change, sometimes they change on hourly basis. So if I am making a price sales order for some steel item, okay, so today there will be a different price and tomorrow there will be a different price, and by the time you go for delivery, at the time there will be a different price. So you want the system to say how the pricing is to be maintained. For example, if I say like I want a price that is existing for today, which means when I make a sales order, system takes the today's price and makes the sales order, and today's price is what that flows to the subsequent document up to billing. Even though the prices change at the time of billing and delivery, system won't take those prices. System will take whatever is taken in the during the time of making the sales order. You have the option of choosing the price which is prevalent at the time of delivery or at the time of billing. As of now, we are taking the pricing date as the date on which we are making the sales order. Okay. Then you can see the EAN UPC. EAN and UPC value comes from your material master, engineering change, or DOM extortion number. These are coming from your material master. And I go to sales B. Here you can see the product hierarchy. Where did we see the product hierarchy and the material group? It was in the basic data or sales organization data of our material master. And division is also coming from our material master. Whereas customer group, price list, price group are taken from customer master. And material pricing group is coming from material master. Sales district is coming from customer master. You can see where how all the master data are coming and blending in the sales order. Okay. Even though it is an item level, item data, even in the item data, you can see the customer data is also taken into consideration. Then we have the, pardon? Yeah. That is code level. that is out of buff. You cannot do anything in that. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay. If you make any changes here, it won't reflect in your master data. The data here. You can change the data here. For example, for this article, it says it is coming from the, it falls under the group of hard disk. But while creating the sales order, I noticed that it must have gone to the group 209. But somebody has mistakenly maintained it in 208 group. Then I can make a change here. But this change is valid only for the sales order. It won't update my material record. Okay, you can change this on order basis. Material master, yeah. It won't change in the material master. We have to go back and change in the material master. But whatever you changes make here, that is valid, that will be available only for this sales order. Okay. Then you have the shipping. In the item level of shipping only, you have the shipping point and the delivering plant. Okay. Why? It is because based on the characteristic of material, I mean, for example, there could be many reasons. Either it's the storage condition, whether it's handling capacity or handling level. It can be maintained in certain plants only or all the plants. Let me say like there are two examples. One is a normal storage item. Let me say, let me take the example of food grains, food articles itself. Let me say there are grains, food grains, and there are some frozen vegetables, I mean vegetables or fruits. Okay. Even though both fall under the edible category, the food grains can be stored in the normal condition, which means covered or sheltered warehouse is enough for that. Okay. Whereas for vegetables and fruits, you need a cold storage. You want this the storage to be maintained at some 5 degrees or 2 degrees something there, so that it is not getting perished. And let us say there are two plants, plant A and plant B. Plant A has the both the storage, I mean normal storage as well as the cold storage, whereas plant B has only normal storage. When your customer is facing a sales order having the food grains as well as vegetables, the system will take the food grains from plant A if it is available there, else it can take from the plant B where only normal storage is available. But for the fruits and vegetables, it must take from only plant A, because only in plant A we have that cold storage facility. Okay. So that is why in the sales order level, so when you are making a sales order, the system will say, okay, item A, I mean the fruits must come from plant A. Item number 20 is your food grains. Food grains is available at plant B, so it must come from plant B. So even though you are raising a single sales order, based on the storage conditions and other parameters, the system will determine different plants for different items. So based on the plant, it won't change the division. It won't change the division. Division is just a classification of product, that's it. That won't change the division, but that will affect your shipping point determination then. Based on the plant, the system can either propose the same shipping point or it can propose different shipping points for different articles. When it proposes different shipping points for different articles, it obviously causes a delivery split. Okay, so you will see those delivery scenarios at a later time. As of now, you just think the plant and shipping points can be determined at the item level because of, for example, let me say like if we are talking about the engineering goods, let me say like plant A only is having the overhead crane which can handle the container, whereas plant B doesn't have the container overhead cranes, but it is having a forklift. There are certain articles that has to be handled in container, so that can be handled only in plant A. It's not about the storage condition here. And in this case, it is about the handling. So it can be handled only in plant A because that has the crane facility. Whereas the other plant need not be handled in the crane overhead crane. It can be handled using the forklift. So that can be handled in the plant B. So in such cases also the system determines different plants and the shipping point is determined based on the delivering plant. Okay. So based on the plant, the system determines a different shipping point which may result in a different route. Okay. So as that is the main reason why in the shipping tab at the header level of the sales order you didn't find the plant or shipping point. Instead those things are found in the item level. Okay. Then you have the order combination here also. You have the partial delivery or maximum delivery. Okay. This is taken from your customer master. Delivering priority is also taken from customer master. Weight and gross weight is taken from our material master. Okay. If you go to billing document, we have the payment terms, info terms, which are normally taken from our customer master. Sales area data. Okay. So go through each tab, each field, make sure that from which field this from which master data this field is getting populated from, and it will give you an idea, better understanding about your SAP as well as the sales process. Tomorrow like you won't feel like I don't know from where this is getting populated. So we had seen the data at header and item, and the third level in which we have the data retention is at the schedule line level. If you see the schedule 9, what we proposed, I asked for a 26th delivery. The system says that on 26th it is confirming me 0, which means on 26th it cannot create a delivery. The possible reason is even though the stock is available, 26 falling on, the material will be having some handling time and other activities. We will see that later. The system here says on 26th it is not possible to give you the 24 pieces you have requested. Instead, I can give it on 28th. That is why the system has created this second line, which is grayed out, which means you are not able to make any changes in this line. The system has told, I cannot give it on 26th, I can give it only on 28th, your 24 pieces. So when I create a delivery for this, the system is going to create it for 28th. So let us see for what is there for our next item, item number 20. I need not go out and check that. Instead, I can press the next item button here itself and see the next item. So I click the next item. Okay, the second item is also having the same delivery date. And the second item is also flowing from the same shipping point, 1200. Okay, so the data are the same. So now I save this sales order and I am going to create a delivery for that. Okay. No, it was doing notification, but since this is sales order, so you have to those are out of system situations basically. You have to tell your system, customer, that the goods are available so and so date only. Okay. So we have created a sales order. What are things we had done? We had done an inquiry, we had done a quotation, and we had done a sales order. Then we had done our copy, data entry in only one place. That is at the, where we made the data entry? Where we entered the items manually. In the inquiry, only in the inquiry. Okay, the system automatically copies the preceding documents and makes your life bit easier. Only thing it showed was like, in the quotation level, it didn't take the price. So that is the only place we entered the data again. If we have maintained the master data for prices properly, it wouldn't have asked that place also. Okay. Now we have done our sales activity, which means we have created the sales order. Now the delivery person takes over. He is going to carry out your delivery activities. So I will brief you like how this situation goes. What happens is like you create a sales order. This sales order creation is done at the head office. Let me say like it is done by the sales people. Okay. Then the scenario moves to warehouse. In the warehouse, there is a delivery clerk who is responsible for all the goods that are coming in and moving out of the warehouse. He only creates the delivery. Normally, warehouse clerk creates both inbound deliveries as well as outbound deliveries. Inbound delivery means the deliveries you are taking from your vendor. Goods are flowing in. That is why it is inbound. Okay. Inbound is related to purchasing. You are buying things, that's why it's coming in. So it is a purchasing activity. So you don't bother about the inbound delivery. Whereas outbound delivery is the delivery is created for sales. It means goods are going out from here. So you have to create the outbound delivery with reference to a sales order. Okay. So the warehouse clerk, every morning he comes. Okay. In real time scenario, the deliveries won't be created on a sales order basis. It is not like the deliveries will be created individually. There is something called as collective run. It means today morning he will come and say like, okay, what are all the sales orders that are due for delivery today? Then the system will select all those sales orders and then he will select everything and click the button create deliveries. So it will automatically create deliveries. You can create hundreds of thousands of deliveries at a single click. Okay. So he normally creates the deliveries, and then he says like, okay, he then passes the responsibility to the picker, because he is a clerk, he cannot go and pick the deliveries, I mean pick the materials from the shelf in the warehouse and then put it in the cart. Okay, so he has to tell the people, picker, to say that, okay, you have to pick these quantities. To tell them to pick the quantities, he is creating something called as transfer order. Transfer order means, what is transfer? Moving of goods from one place to other place. The transfer order says like, this goods is moving from this place to another place, but the movement of goods is within the warehouse. For example, the article is lying in the shelf number 2 and bin number 5. Okay. The source is shelf number 2, bin number 5, and the movement is, the goods is moved to the destination of your shipping cart or some other location, let me say location number 916. So the goods are moving from shelf 2 to shelf 916. Okay. This movement is within the warehouse. So the transfer order moves the goods within the warehouse and not to the customer. So the picker takes a printout of this transfer order and he uses it as reference, takes all the goods, puts in the shipping cart, and then brings back to the your delivery clerk. Okay. So while picking itself, he normally confirms. Sometimes like he confirms in this, in his level, if he is given a PDA, he will be confirming the quantity in PDA. Then he will be manually ticking in the transfer order saying that, okay, I have picked so and so quantity. Let us assume that everything is fine. There is no discrepancy. Okay. He comes to the sales clerk and says that I have taken so and so goods. Okay. Then the clerk confirms it and then does the goods issue. He issues the goods to the customer. Okay. The even though the term goods issue says like it is issued to the customer, in real time scenario, goods issue means the goods are leaving your warehouse premises and moving out to the customer. A journey is embarked basically. Okay. Which means the moment it leaves your warehouse premises, it becomes the property of your customer. At that stage only you say like, okay, my goods has gone out, it is customer's property hereafter. So the customer's receivable from my customer is increased, my inventory is reduced, my billing, so I tell the billing people, okay, you update your billing index so that you can raise the billing on so and so date. So these kind of activities are taking in the delivery. So which means here we are going to have three or more steps. It might look complicated, that is why I am taking some time to explain this scenario in a layman language. Okay. First we create a delivery, that is the role of a delivery clerk. Okay. So based on the delivery, we create a transfer order, that is also the delivery clerk's role. Then the transfer order is given to the picker. Okay. Then it becomes the picker's role. Okay. Picker takes the goods and comes back. Okay. And finally, once it comes back to the delivery clerk, he has to do a PDA. Then he opens the delivery again and does the PDA. This is the activity that is we are going to see now. Delivery clerk opens the delivery and does the PGI, goods issue, post goods issue. Yeah, okay. So let us create a delivery first. Go to sales and distribution. Our sales part is over. So close that folder and open the shipping and transportation. Go to outbound delivery. Create. We are creating for a single document as of now. We hadn't seen the collective processing. So single document with reference to sales order. So my sales order is this and this is my selection date and this is my shipping point. The selection date is what the system shows. Okay, for example, what it showed? It showed 28th. Okay. If I give before date, it will throw an error saying like no delivery is found up to the, no schedule line is found up to the selected date. So to avoid that, I am giving the selection date as the date that I had seen in my delivery schedule, I mean sales order schedule line. Okay. Here also you can see, wherever in SAP you go, you can find the tabs, lot of tabs. The data are segregated in the tabs basically. So first is our picking activity. So if you see, there is a picking date and time, which means when this delivery is going to be picked. So that is given the, then it says like from which warehouse it has to be picked from, that is 012, and what is the status of it, whether you can, it, I mean you can see the status here, it is not picked and it requires a transfer order, which means you have to create a transfer order to carry out the picking activity. Then there are some tabs, like there is something called as transport. Transport planning means you have to plan in which route this goods can travel in, and you have to call your freight forwarder and fix up the vehicle. Okay. So this activity is normally done on 25th, on the date of creating the delivery. Okay. Picking and transportation are done almost on the same day. Then you do the loading. Loading is done on the next day, that is on 26th, and you plan to carry out your goods issue process on 27th. If all, I mean, can you see that all the activities are not taking place at the same day or same time? So you have initiated the delivery, that is the first thing you are doing here, and the rest of the activities will follow at its own schedule. Okay. So now I am saving the delivery first. So my delivery 18001, my delivery has been created. Okay, once I had created the delivery, what is my logical next step? Yeah, I have to create a transfer order. Okay, let me close the outbound delivery. I go for, my transfer order is basically a picking activity. So I go to picking, create transfer order, create transfer order for single document. Okay. I enter the document number, I enter the warehouse number. That's enough. Okay. Here there are so many options. As of now, let us see the system guided. I create it, I click the generate PO item, then I save it. The moment I click the generate PO item, the system automatically confirms, okay, that I have picked so and so. Now I go back to the delivery. Transfer order is just a single step, yes? Yeah, plant number and warehouse number are different. Okay, we will see that in the customizing later. Then I have created a transfer order and I have picked it, and since I pressed the generate PO item, I have confirmed it also. Now I am going to do the post goods issue. My picking activity is over. If I go to the delivery again, I could see my daily overall picking status is fully picked and the transfer order is confirmed. Because I had clicked the generate PO item, it automatically confirmed it. And can you see, now the picked quantity is automatically populated. So now I am doing a post goods issue and I am shifting the responsibility or ownership to my customer. Last time also we got stuck in this particular step because there was some problem. Okay. Now we have created. Now I had created the delivery. I had done the post goods issue. The goods had left to the customer. Okay. Now the customer says, okay, he has received the so and so goods. Now I am going to raise an invoice against the delivery. I am going to, my sales is over, my shipping is over. Now my billing is there. Okay, I click the billing document, create. I create it for a delivery, because this is my delivery related billing. So I enter the delivery number, press enter, that's it. I didn't do anything else. Okay. The system automatically shows this is what my billing document is going to be. I have delivered 24 pieces to the customer and 48 pieces of the item number 2. I press save. In the billing document, I didn't have anything to enter. I just enter the delivery number and press enter. That's it. Now the system has created the billing document. I'm going to the billing document in the change mode to see what is the entry it has created. Okay. This is my billing document or invoice. What is the billing document? Billing document is an interface between your sales as well as the accounting. Because during here only you will say like, okay, this 9480 euros, okay, this must be posted, split into some components and it must be posted to some account. So let me see where it has posted in the account. I click the accounting overview. The system can show me what are all the documents it has created as a part of financial activities. It could be your accounting document or profit center document or profitability analysis. Okay. Let me choose the accounting document and click the details. The system will take me to the another screen where it shows the overview of accounting, to which account the customer receivable is posted to, or which account this sales revenue is posted to. Okay, item number, so it shows, this is my customer account. Customer's account is T-62801. He is now credited with, is it a credit or debit? I always get this out. We will be debited. But when you are, so when he is saying, we will be debited, he will be credited. Is it right? Yeah, that's right. Yeah. Okay. So the customer is credited with 28,257 euros, whereas that amount is split into 3. Okay, for item number 1 and item number 2, okay, it has taken so and so for the domestic revenue, and it has taken the tax part separately and is posting to separate general ledger account. So this is your typical sales order to cash cycle. Let me know, I mean just mentally go through the cycle once and let me know like where you feel like you will be getting stuck. We'll do that again. Because if you are not comfortable with this process, then you won't be able to know the, then you will be finding it a bit difficult to follow the next coming session. No, we didn't do anything manually. We just created the invoice. System automatically posted these things. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, they can see that. Yeah. Because there are few transactions which are the link or which work close with the other modules. For example, when you do the post goods issue, at the time the link is very much close between your MM and sales and distribution. Because since your goods are moving out, you have to tell the MM people that goods are moving out, so you plan your replenishment accordingly. So those inventory things are related with MM. Okay. So when you do the CGA, at that junction, the interface between SD and MM is very crucial. And when you do the billing, here the link is between SD and SI, finance people. Okay. Now, normally we, sales and distribution people, sometimes like, it depends on the organization structure, basically. Like who carries the activity. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. I talked about the document flow. Okay. Document flow, this button, can you see? One, it is like an envelope along with the wings. Okay. So this button is from here. Yeah? The invoice is raised from sales and distribution, whereas the postings are done from finance. This button I am showing, that display document flow, you can see that in all your sales documents. For example, if I go to, it is here in billing, okay, slash in VA02, if I go to sales order, you can find that button here, okay, display document flow. If I go to delivery, slash in VL03 and display mode, here also you can find it here. This document flow is one of the most important and useful functionalities in SAP. With which you can, you remember only the sales order number, you don't know what is the subsequent deliveries or invoices. And sometimes you remember this is my delivery, but I don't know what is the corresponding sales order. By using this functionality, you can see everything, all the documents that are linked with the sales order process in a single click. So if, right now I am in the delivery. Okay. Let me click that. Yeah, I'll speak to that guy now. Okay, I'll speak to that guy and I'll get few people the credentials in the server itself. Okay. So can you see, right now we clicked from the delivery document. So that is why this delivery document is highlighted. So we had a preceding document. We had so many preceding documents. Sales order, quotation and inquiry. And we have the succeeding documents like your transfer order. This goods issue document is automatically generated. We don't need to do anything to create it. Okay. So that is a goods issue document. After that, we created the invoice. Here you can, parallel you can see the status. You have completed, completed. For example, if I had created a sales order, my sales order is having two items. But if I had created only a delivery for only one item, then the sales order will be shown as partially referenced or partially delivered. Similarly, here we have just posted, we have sent the invoice to our customer by raising the invoice, that's it. We didn't receive the incoming payment, so that is why it is showing as not clear. Okay, that incoming payment can be normally done by the, we can just learn the transaction how to do that, but it is normally done by the finance people. So if you know how to settle the incoming payment, it is fine. Even if you don't know, that is also fine. That doesn't harm you, basically. And from the document flow, you can see the documents. You can go into the documents directly. For example, right now I am in the delivery. I want to see the inquiry I have made for that. So I select that line and click the display document. So the system takes me to that particular document in a display mode. Okay. If I want to make any changes, I can make the changes here. And I can always come back to the document flow without losing track of where I was. So this is the document flow functionality and this is one of the most useful functionality. Sometimes I remember only sales orders. I don't know what are the other things I have created. Sometimes I remember only the delivery number. So some link I will take it up and some that I will find it out. Okay, what are all the preceding as well as the succeeding. So whenever hereafter you create a sales order or billing document, I would appreciate if you go into the document flow and see these activities. And if you go to the billing, if you create a billing document, go into the billing, go into the item, accounting overview, and find out whether the amount has been posted into the accounts rightly. Many times what happens, like the system creates a billing document, but it won't create a accounting document. It means it won't post to accounts. Even though we can say like posting to accounts is financial thing, the data must go from us. which means if we are having some mistake, then it won't flow from us to the account. So you must, many times it happens like the system will save the invoice, but it will not create the accounting document. But people won't know, or they don't realize that it has not been created. Okay. So just take a moment, like there is something called as goods issue document, which we didn't see because we didn't create that explicitly. This goods issue document is automatically created by the system. Take some time to go through that document. So select that and go to display document. See what is there inside the goods issue document. Because we didn't create it automatically. So what was there? It says like what is the item, how many pieces were there, from which plant, from which location it moved. So what is the, this minus case like your inventory is getting depleted, and this 601 is the movement. Once again, the 601 is the movement type, which means it shows from which direction are the goods are moving. So what is 601 for me? Now 601 is the goods issue flow. So goods issue for delivery. So that is why it is saying as 601. Okay. Yeah, Preeti? Yeah. This document links is going to the MM basically. They will be using this material slip and other things. Okay. So take some time. Whenever you create a document, take some time, initially at least, for 4 or 5 documents. Take some time, go through each field and find out where it is coming from. That will give you an idea, okay, this data is coming from so-and-so master data. So tomorrow if you are having any problem, for example, tomorrow suddenly you are encountered with a problem that the payment terms are not populated. That is why your billing documents are not getting created. So at that time you must know from where the payment terms are taken from. That is why I am saying like go through each field and go through for all the documents you go through each field. That will give you a very good understanding of. Once you have understood the system completely at this time, hereafter then it will be like a cakewalk. Okay, you are asking something, Adib. Not necessary. That depends on, because whenever they ask for this kind of SD plus MM or SD plus F,